सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंतां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुतिर्थि प्राणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बाधारणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ नक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ब्रह्माणुजातिपुरं येदागश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तपुंहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं शुरुहि शरणं हं प्रपद्येऽहं। शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेश नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्वेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहन्नमत्वं नित्यमे निश्चितामितिः। राज्ञः मरणानन्तरं ब्रह्मलोकप्राप्तिः। सो शुभ संतति अटेंड ब्रह्मलोक आफ्टर द शरीर आर ड्रॉप्ड ऑफ। इत्थं शुभ संततिर नाम राजा तर्कदृष्टे स्वपुत्रस्य वचनं श्रुत्वा सर्व संशयान् समस्तं समस्त मनशोकांश्च संत्यज्य पूर्णानन्दम अवाप। सो हियर इटसेल्फ ही वाज डूइंग उपासना। सो तर्कदृष्टे हे स्वपुत्रस्य वचनं श्रुत्वा एज टू हाउ दी उपासना हैज टू बी डन विच दर्शन हैज टू बी फॉलोड। सो हैविंग हर्ड दैट फ्रॉम हिज ओन सन सर्व संशयान समस्त मनशोकांश संत्यज्य ऑल हिज शोका वेंट अवे। सो ही गेव अप दी ग्रीफ दैट ही हैड वॉज ड्यू टू अटैचमेंट विद दी with basically everything that is happening in his life, meaning he had manda vairagya, so he was not really interested and he was not able to enjoy the riches, and he also had dukkha of his children leaving, and tarkadrishti told him which upasana to follow, thereby he became sukhi. But then he also had doubts about darshana shastra, that was also resolved, therefore purnanandam avapa following that upasana. Karana brahma upasanayam bahu bahushah chittalayam chakara. So he attained samadhi many a time following karana brahma upasana, that was the reason for his purnananda prapti in samadhi, not outside samadhi, in samadhi. तर्कदृष्टिमेव स्वगुरुत्वेन भावयित्वा विशिष्टं राज्यं तस्मादात्। सो तस्मै स्वपुत्राय टू तर्कदृष्टि ही गेव हिज एंटायर राज्य बिकॉज ही गॉट अ टेस्ट फॉर दिस समाधि। नाउ कंसिडरिंग हिम एज ओन गुरु ही गेव हिज राज्य टू हिम एंड देन ही पुत्रापि What did Tarkadrishti do? Putra api Tarkadrishtihi uttama upadesha kartrutvad guru padvim bheje. So even his own son became a guru. He was befitting the status of the guru, although the son, because he gave the right upadesha to the father. Tadeta sarvam brahma vidyayaha mahatmyameva. And it does not come just about like that. It is the mahatmya of Brahma Vidya, not of the Putra himself. Brahma Vidya makes the person guru there. Shubha Santati Maranam. So this Raja, Shubha Santati, grew old and he passed away. Now, how did he die? That is discussed here. Katipaya Divasarantaram Raja Pranan Sanjahau. He gave up his prana after a long long time. Sanakadi muni gana prapyam brahmalokancha jagama, attained the same brahmaloka as attained by Sanakadi munis. Nahi rajnyaha marane deshakaladi नहि राज्ञः मरणे देशकालादि नियमोक्तिरस्ति. So, as an aside, what has been said is that there is no niyama to the Raja's death. Now, here particularly if you take the case of Shubha Santati, because a king can die on the battleground also, there is no niyama as to when he'll die, there is no niyama. But in his case, he was an Upasaka, and what was said earlier, that an Upasaka has a niyama if he has to go to Brahmaloka, there is a particular niyama in which he has to niyamas in those niyamas he has to give up his body. This was mentioned earlier. Now that is being countered. Asya ayam abhiprayah upasaka marana vishe na deshakaladi vyapeksha asti. Earlier vishesha apeksha nasti. What has been said earlier, vishesha apeksha asti. Now it is contradicted. अहनि वा रात्रो वा दक्षिणायने वा उत्तरायने वा शुद्धे वा अपि अशुद्धे देशे मृतः अपि उपासना बलात् स सर्वथा अपि देवयानेन पथा ब्रह्मलोकमेव गच्छति. दैट्स नॉट अ फैक्ट एज पर व्हाट वी हैव सीन इन द फिफ्थ चैप्टर. सो हियर अदृष्टि प्रसंगे Adrishti is the second son who was taught upasana by the guru in the panchama taranga. So adrishti prasange purvam deshakala adyapeksha syaditi yaduktam tad yoga sahita upasaka vishayam. There the upasanas taught were different than the upasana taught here. There it was a yogika prakriya, and particularly the asana in which one has to give up prana, how the prana has to be brought into the hridayakasha, and then one should launch oneself through the sahasrara, that was mentioned there briefly. But that is only true if particular types of upasanas are done. Here what is being done? In each upasana you are looking at whoever is ishtadevata. Here it is not ishtadevata upasana. Any upasana as followed with the niyama for a particular anubhava or a particular prapti, ishta devata prapti, that has particular niyamas. Here every devata is being looked at as karana brahma. Thereby it is not an upasana for a phala which is limited. So what is being said here, adrishti prasange purvam deshakaladya peksha syaditi yaduktam tad yoga sahita upasaka vishayam. Kevala ishvara eka sharanatam gatasya upasakasya. So kevala ishvara eka sharanatam gatasya. One who has taken sharana to any ishta devata as ishvara, complete, jagat karana brahma. That kind of upasaka has no niyama. So upasakasya tasya naivasti deshakaladyapaksha. Pratipaditaha cha ayam artha sutra bhashyakaradibhi. So Vyasacharya sutrakara, Brahma sutrakara and bhashyakara explain this in detail as to an upasaka who does karana brahma upasana has no niyama. He will attain Brahmaloka, niyama in the sense what? Niyama in dropping the sharira. Tarka drishte deha pataha. So anyway, before that, let's look at a tippana. There is one tippana which I missed last, I should have started there. So Bhedavadi, there is a tippana on Bhedavadi as to the comparison which was given earlier about this Andha Golangula Nyaya. So how is it that the Bheda drishti, Bhedavadi fits into the Krurata explained in that Nyaya. So that is explained in the Tippana. Bhedavadina hi Acharyaha Swayamapi Swashastrokta Parameshwara Praptirupa Mokshadyanubhava Shunyaha Vartante. So all the Dvaitins who talk about Bheda, being satya, swashastra ukta parameshwara prapti rupa mokshadyanubhava shunyaha. They themselves are bereft of anubhava of that kind of a parameshwara prapti which is talked about in their own granthas. Otherwise that aikya siddhi that they are looking for with the ishta devata itself will take away this bhedavada. So what has been said? Swayamapi. Swayamapi asiddhaha. So what are they going to help others? So there is a sadistic behavior as though क्रमशः अपि उक्त उपासनादि रूप मोक्ष साधना साधन रहिताः शिष्य वित्तापहारार्थं शिष्यत्वेन अन्यान् वशीकर्तुं स्वसमय संप्रदाय चिन्हित सांकेतिक मंत्रोपदेशं कुर्वन्ति. सो दे डू दि मंत्रोपदेश दे गिव दि मंत्रोपदेश टू दि शिष्यास् एज पर देर ओन संप्रदाय विच विल लीड टू नॉट ऐक्य अस्मद् उपदेशेन शास्त्रीयात् सन्मार्गात् भ्रष्टानां सतां यावज्जीयं जन्म निष्फलं किल स्याद् इति परितापो न तेषां जायते. दे डोंट हैव दिस परिताप, दे डोंट हैव दिस करुणा आल्सो दैट अदर्स लाइफ विल बी वेस्टेड लाइक देयर लाइफ इज वेस्टेड. दे डोंट हैव दैट करुणा, देयरफॉर so actually karuna is a better word here. Paritapa has been said that they don't have the shok at all. They don't feel that others life should not be wasted, my life has been wasted, why waste someone else's life by giving them something erroneous, limited. Therefore evam daya virahita, and now comes the karuna lacking, evam daya virahitah vanchakah eva bhedavadinah dvaitinah. And that is how this andha the nyaya, andha golangula nyaya applies to dvaitavadis. So back to Moola 535 says tarka drishter dehapatah paramatma aikyam. So tarka drishti lived on and went on to rule over the kingdoms, but then over of time his prarabdha got over and then he attained aikya videha mukti. Tada tarka drishtihi dridatara dvaita tuchchata nischayah san. So he was one who had tuchchata nischaya with the prapancha being there. So he was very clear that prapancha isn't there, tuchchatva nischaya is there. So he didn't have to think over and withdraw himself at all because he was already withdrawn. The things got done by mere prarabdha. Thereby rajya karyam akhilam api savadanam manaha eva akarot. He had to, considering that the prapancha is tuchha, he had to take effort and be cautious in running the prapancha, basically running the kingdom. So it is all the three lokas, therefore he was very attentive to get things done because it is tuchha, otherwise he will not feel like doing anything. So the reason he took all the more interest is because it is not going to affect him at all. So the way the prarabdha drove him, he attentively followed it through. So he was not negligent just because it is tuchha. He was not negligent because the others who are also really not existent, but still they'll feel the prapancha, they'll feel the samsara, they'll feel the way he rules over. Thereby savadhana manaha san eva rajya karyam akhilam सह अकरोत् तर्क दृष्टि न क्वचिदपि सक्तः अभूत्. सो ही नेवर गॉट अटैच्ड टू इट दो सदा ब्रह्मण्येव तस्य निष्ठा अभूत्. ही हैड ब्रह्मनिष्ठा प्रारब्धान्ते च निश्चलं धाम कैवल्यं वाप एंड आफ्टर द एंड ऑफ प्रारब्ध ही अटेंड द कैवल्य मीनिंग द देह विच इज लिमिटिंग हिम हाउ बिकॉज एनी प्रेयर ऑल्सो कैन बी आंसर्ड बेस्ड ऑन द कैपेसिटी दैट वी हैव लेट्स से एज अ गुरु यू प्रे टू समवन दैट गुरु कैन ओनली गिव यू सो मच एज द लिमिटेशंस अलाउ Even the guru is limited by the sharira to you know whatever is physically to be done which needs the sharira to get things done that will definitely be limited by the sharira even if guru has is a jivan mukta his physical deliverance will be limited by the physical body there is no question about it so prarabdha ante after the prarabdha ends that limitation also goes away therefore I mean if you recall the talk of Swami Paramarthanand ji about Swami Omkaranand ji the videha mukti is celebrated it is not a moment for shoka people who have grief about the guru passing away attaining mahasamadhi they have misunderstood videha mukti It is okay to feel grief from one's own perspective, saying that I miss the guru, I miss the body of the guru, I miss the activities of the guru, I miss the rakshana of the guru, like Dharma Rakshana Samiti or anything that is led by Swami Omkaranandji. I miss that, and thereby feel the grief. That is understood. But to say that he passed away in his prime or whatever, that is misunderstanding the gurutva itself. So it's a moment to celebrate that he has become Ishvara. There are no limitations anymore. So whatever you ask for also, the prayer to the Guru will go all the more better now because he has merged with Ishvara. This should be the bhavana. So that is mentioned here. Prarabdhantacha nischalam dhama kaivalyam avapa. What is this nischala? Nischalam dhama kaivalyam. Atma. कूटस्थ साक्षी परमात्मना अभिन्नः अभूत देहश्च वस्मीभूतः सो आत्मा विच हैज एवर बीन नॉन डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ब्रह्म परमात्मा वॉज समहाउ फाइंडिंग इट्स लिमिटेशंस इन देह दैट देह हैज बिकम भस्मीभूतः यद्यपि कूटस्थ परमात्मनो सदा भेद एव आस्ते तथापि उपाधिना भिन्न इव अभात So, upadina bhinna iva abhas. There is an abhas of bhinnatva as long as sharira is there, although kutastha is never different from paramatma. Upadi layat bhedaha tirodhade. However, once the prarabdha ends, the upadi laya takes place, and once upadi laya takes place, then this bheda pratiti also goes away. Thereby paramatmana abheda iti asya ayam abhiprayah thereby paramatma abheda takes place in complete measure after videha mukti and this is figurative of course paramatma abheda means there is no merging abheda is there is no difference that is known to others also about the jnani now So what is the idea there? Videha muktau parameshwarena abhedaha siddhyati natu shuddha chaitanyena. Shuddha chaitanya is nirguna brahma. When videha moksha, videha mukti takes place, that time the abheda is not with nirguna brahma. It is with saguna brahma. Shuddha chaitanyena na abhedaha परमेश्वरेण ईश्वरः नॉट परमात्मा परमेश्वर परमात्मा कैन बी नोन एज निर्गुण एज वेल एज सगुण बट परमेश्वर इज नॉट निर्गुण इट इज सगुण दिस इज दी जनरल अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ कोर्स इन विवरण दिस ईश्वर सगुण ब्रह्म इज नेवर डिफरेंट फ्रॉम निर्गुण ब्रह्म इन फैक्ट इफ यू रिकॉल ही इज दी बिंब एंड जीवा इज दी प्रतिबिंब ईश्वर इज दी बिंब Not Nirguna Brahma. Then when we are saying that Videha Mukti is अभेदा विद ब्रह्मा देर वी मीन अभेदा विद परमेश्वर विद सगुण ब्रह्मा. Now this is something which is not discussed at many places. You will not find this. And some people have a question here. How can that be? That is because each and every jiva, even without the knowledge, is always having abheda with nirguna brahma. Never does one have abheda with saguna brahma. That's why the teaching to know the abheda with nirguna brahma, that you always are abhinna from nirguna brahma. Jnani knows this. Jivan mukta has nishtha in that jnana. Ajnani does not know it, does not know it, and nishtha is not possible. Ayam artha shariraka bhashye chaturtha adhyay pratyapadi tatrayam prasanga. So in Brahma Sutra, this is discussed in the bhashya in the fourth chapter. What is the context there? Videha muktau satya sankalpatvadi praptiriti jaimini matam. So Jaimini Muni says that in Videha Mukti, what happens is that there is satya sankalpatvadi prapti. Like Ishwara is satya sankalpa, similarly this Videha Mukta becomes satya sankalpa. Audulomi mate satya sankalpatvadyabhavaha kathyate. Whereas another Muni, Audulomi, disagrees with this mata, and what does he say? Satya sankalpatva is not possible even on Videha Mukti. Siddhantetu, Bhagavan Bhashyakara says satya sankalpatvadinam bhava bhavau ubhau api uktau. However, Vedanti says that satya sankalpattvam is possible, lack of satya sankalpattvam is also possible. Both are possible in Videha Mukti. How so? Tasya ayam abhiprayaha. Videha muktau ishwarabhedaha jayate. One becomes one with Ishwara. One is already one with Nirguna Brahma, meaning there is no other. But in Videha Mukti, what happens? What is the difference between a jnani and an ajnani? One has knowledge of Aikya, another does not have knowledge of Aikya, meaning Abheda with Nirguna Brahma, although being Abhinna from Nirguna Brahma. In both cases, both are Abhinna from Nirguna Brahma. One knows, another doesn't know. But Jnani is Jivan Mukta, but until Videha Mukti, his Deha is binding on him, meaning imposing physical restrictions. So what happens is that the sharira, which is causing physical restrictions on Videha Mukti, this sthula sharira anyway resolves into the fundamental karanas, meaning panchamahabhutas, in the case of ajnani also and jnani also. But sukshma sharira continues in the case of ajnani after prarabdha ends, meaning after mrityu. But in the case of jnani, the sukshma sharira also disintegrates into karana. What is this karana really? Parinami karana. That parinami karana is maya, which is Ishwara shakti, which is one with Ishwara. Nirguna Brahma does not have maya. Saguna Brahma has maya shakti. So Ishwara has maya shakti, called as avyakta shakti, in which is parinami upadana karana. In that upadana, the jnani's antakkarana sukshma sharira merges, disintegrates. Thereby, when the merger takes place in Ishwara, how can jnani be different from Ishwara? This is the idea. So tasyaayam avipraya videha muktau Ishwara bhedo jayate. ऐश्वर सत्य संकल्पत्वादयः मुक्त पुरुषे जीवांतरैः व्यवक्रियन्ते. सो अदर जीवास आर लुकिंग एट ईश्वर, नॉट एट निर्गुण ब्रह्म. दे आर लुकिंग एट द क्रिएटर एज ईश्वर. दे प्रे टू ईश्वर, दे प्रे टू गुरु ऑल्सो. आफ्टर विदेह मुक्ति ऑल्सो, इफ दे आर प्लेइंग टू दिस जीवन मुक्ता वॉज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द ज्ञानी इन शरीर. after sharira drops away, he cannot answer prayers as nirguna brahma. Nirguna brahma knows nothing else other than itself. So where is nirguna brahma going to answer your prayers? Tomorrow is Shankara Jayanti. Starts today as tithi wise, but then tomorrow suryodaya time there will be Shankara Jayanti. So in Shankara Jayanti puja that we do, whose puja is it? It is with the murti, it is with the form. Shankaracharya is nirguna brahma, just like you and I are nirguna brahma. The puja is not to nirguna brahma. Who is it to? It is to Shankaracharya with form. It is that guru where you want that form, not any other form. And that form is an expression, just like any form is an expression of Ishvara, which is what we saw in the ending section just before this. What Tarkadrishti has taught the Raja Subhasantati should not be lost upon us. He said you can do upasana, you can pray to any deity as Karana Brahma, as Ishvara. This Guru is also the form taken by Ishvara to bless us. So you invoke his blessings through that particular form. You invoke Ishvara's blessing, not Nirguna Brahma's blessings. So from the perspective of Jivas, Jivantaraihi Vyavakhriyante Mukta Purushe what? Aishvara Satya Sankalpatvadayaha. That's why we say Guru is not different from Ishvara, all the more so after Videha Mukti. Paramartha Drishtyatu. Now this is the Bhava Bhavo. Satya Sankalpatva Bhava has been explained. Abhava of Satya Sankalpa remains to be explained. That is explained as by saying Paramartha Drishtyatu Sahapi Ishvara Shuddha Chaitanyam Eva. If you look at the perspective of Ishvara himself, when you look at Ishvara, from the perspective of the Jiva, Ishvara is Sarvashaktiman. From the perspective of Ishvara himself, he is Shuddha Chaitanya. He has no attachment with anything. Who is Asanga through and through. Na tatrasti gunalesho api. So Ishvara himself, although called as Saguna from the perspective of the Jiva, from his own perspective he has no gunas. There is no he or she vyavahara possible even in Ishvara from the perspective of Ishvara, because he knows that he is Shuddha Chaitanya. Nirgunatvadeva satya sankalpatvadya bhavah tatra. So in Ishvara, from the perspective of Ishvara or from the perspective of the Videha Mukta who has merged with Ishvara, he is Shuddha Chaitanya. Therefore, Satya Sankalpatva is not possible in Nirguna Brahma, that guna lacking, any guna lacking. Samsara Dashayam Api Jivaha Parmartata Nirguna Shuddhascha. Tathapi Samsara Dashayam Avidyaya Tasmin Kartrutva Bhuktrutva Janarthav Pratiyate. Every Jiva is Nirguna Brahma. Even during Samsara, he is Nirguna Brahma. Thereby, due to the influence of avidya, which veils the Nirguna Brahmatvam of this Jiva, he considers himself as Karta Bhokta. Ishwarasyajuna kadachidapi swasmin paratrava samsara pratitirasti. So kadachidapi nasti Ishwarasya pratiti. As what? As samsara being there, samsara is neither there for you nor for me. That is the pratiti of Ishvara. Atahaiva Ishvara sarvada asangaha nirguna shuddhascha. Thereby, Vivarna Sampradaya says that Ishvara is always asanga and nirguna. From the perspective of Ishvara, tasmad yaha abheda Ishvarena uchyate sa shuddha brahma abheda eva. So whichever abheda is being mentioned here with Ishvara after Videha Mukti of that Jiva, in this case Tarka Drishti, that is abheda with Shuddha Brahma itself. Although it is Ishvara, Ishvara himself is Shuddha Brahma Nirguna. Ishvara abheda Shuddha Bheda, Ishvara abheda Shuddha Brahma abheda nasyaditi yadi manyeta. If someone says that no, Ishvara is not Nirguna Brahma, then they don't even know what is the impact. They don't know what is the repercussion of that statement. Tarhi Ishvarasya Shuddha Brahmana Tu Aikatmyam Naiva सिद्धेत कदाचिदपि देन ईश्वर हू इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम निर्गुण ब्रह्म इफ समवन सेज दैट ईश्वर इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम निर्गुण ब्रह्म ईश्वर इज सगुण दिस जीवा हैज ऑलवेज बीन मेंशनड एज व्हाट जीवो ब्रह्मैव नापरः एंड द टीचिंग इज दैट यू आर ऑलरेडी निर्गुण ब्रह्म यू जस्ट हैव टू नो सो व्हाट विल बी द केस ईश्वर इज भिन्न फ्रॉम निर्गुण ब्रह्म सगुणत्वात् Similarly, and in the same breath, you'll be saying Jiva is Nirguna Brahma. Avidya dashayam, samsara dashayam api. So, samsara dashayam api, Jivaha Nirguna Brahma abhinnaha, whereas Ishvara is Nirguna Brahma abhinnaha. So, what kind of situation have you landed yourself in by making such a statement? Ishvara will never become Nirguna Brahma, Jiva is always Nirguna Brahma. Meaning Ishvara is inferior to Jiva. This is the kind of repercussion one has by making such a statement. Sarvada yataha Jiva vad Ishvarasya Aupadeshikam Jnanam Videha Mokshashchana Kadapi Sambhavet. Due to this reason, what will happen? Jiva is always Nirguna Brahma. He just has to know, whereas Ishvara is different from Nirguna Brahma, he can never become Mukta. So Ishvara is never Mukta and Jiva has a potential of being Mukta. So Jiva vad Ishvarasya Aupadeshikam Jnanam Videha Mokshashchana Kadapi Sambhave. So Jivan Mukti is not possible for Ishvara. Videha Mukti is not possible for Ishvara, whereas both are possible in the case of Jiva. Thereby, what is the conclusion that one has to draw? सर्वदा तत्स्वरूप न शुद्धम स्यात् तस्मात् जीवापेक्षया न्यूनः ईश्वरः ईश्वर इज इन्फीरियर टू जीवा दिस इज द काइंड ऑफ एरोनियस कंक्लूजन वन विल लैंड इन बाय सेइंग दैट सगुण ईश्वर इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम निर्गुण सदा बद्धश्च स्यात् ईश्वर विल बिकम बद्ध तस्मात् वक्ष्यमाण रीत्या एव मन्तव्यम् देयरफॉर द फ्लॉलेस अंडरस्टैंडिंग इज एज फॉलोस नास्ति आवरणम ईश्वरस्य अत एव न उपदेशजन्य ज्ञानापेक्षा ईश्वर डज नॉट हैव आवरण लाइक जीवा हैज देयरफॉर ईश्वर डज नॉट हैव एक्सपेक्टेंसी ऑफ ज्ञान मीनिंग उपदेश ज्ञानजन्य उपदेश इज नॉट नीडेड फॉर ईश्वर आवरणाभावात् न भ्रांतिरप्यस्ति सिंस आवरण इजंट देयर विक्षेप इज नॉट पॉसिबल भ्रांति इज नॉट पॉसिबल इन द केस ऑफ ईश्वर तस्मात् नित्य सर्वज्ञ नित्य मुक्तश्च देयरफॉर ईश्वर इज ऑलवेज सर्वज्ञ एंड ऑलवेज मुक्त मीनिंग ही इज निर्गुण माया तत्कार्य जातंच न आत्मनि प्रतीयते अतएव सदा असंग शुद्धश्च सो ईश्वर इज ऑलवेज असंग एंड ऑलवेज शुद्ध बिकॉज माया एंड माया कार्य इज नॉट देयर इन ईश्वर आत्मा एवं रीत्या ईश्वराभेद एव शुद्ध चैतन्याभेद इत्युच्यते देयरफॉर ईश्वराभेद शुद्धाभेद हैव द सेम सेंस इन रियलिटी फ्रॉम द पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ द जीवा ही लुक्स एट ईश्वर डिफरेंटली बिकॉज निर्गुण इज नॉट अवेलेबल फॉर कॉग्निशन यूजिंग द प्रमाणास अवेलेबल सो ज्ञान अलोन कैन लेट यू नो निर्गुणत्व ऑफ योर ओन सेल्फ यू कैनॉट ऑब्जेक्टिफाई निर्गुण Ishvara can be objectified as per the descriptions given in the Shastra through Upasana, etc. Therefore, Ishvarabheda is possible in Videha Mukti, which is non-different from Shuddha Chaitanya Abheda, which is anyway not needed because every Jiva is Shuddha Chaitanya Abhinna. One just has to know. So, after knowing, one anyway has attained, figuratively also one has attained Nirguna Brahma, or Shuddha Chaitanya. What is not attained is due to the Prarabdha Sharira continuing, Sharira is blocking the Abheda with Ishvara. So Ishvara Abheda is what takes place in Videha Mukti and that Ishvara Abheda eva Shuddha Chaitanya Abheda Nirguna Brahma Abheda ityuchyate. Ittam drishtantena api Ishvarena eva Abheda Siddhyati. Now an example is explained with the Avachedavada. यथा मठे घटनाशे घटाभावदशायां मठाकाशे घटाकाशो विलीयते न तु महाकाशे. Now you take the example, a pot is kept in a room, it is not kept outside, it is kept in a room. In a matha, there is a ghata. There is a matha akasha and there is a ghata akasha, which is ghata avachinna. So ghata avachinna ghata akasha and matha avachinna matha akasha, although they are one, there is pratiti that there is a ghata akasha and matha akasha. So when ghata gets videha mukti, meaning you break the pot or the pot gets broken, then the ghatakasha, where does it merge? So if the merger figuratively has to be discussed also, the ghatakasha cannot merge with mahakasha, the akasha outside the matha, it has to merge with the mathakasha. Therefore, yatha mathe ghatanashe sati ghatabhavadashayam mathakashe ghatakasho viliyate natu mahakashe. Ghatakasha does not merge with Mahakasha, it merges with Mathakasha. Similarly, one merges with Ishvara, not with Nirguna Brahma. Tatha Vidushaha Shariram Api Ishvara Krita Brahmande Eva Vinashyati. So where is the Vidvan Sharira, Vidvat Sharira going to merge in? It is going to merge in Ishvara. Because Upadana Karana is Ishvara, his Maya is Upadana Karana. Akhilam api Brahmandam Ishvara Sharira Bhuta Mayayam Antarbhavati. All Shariras are part of Maya as they are part of Maya Karya. Therefore, the Vilaya will be into Karana. Karana Maya. Vidushaha tu Atma Videha. Vidushaha Atma tu Videha Mokshe Brahmandat Nabhir Gachati. It cannot go outside Brahmanda, it has to remain in Brahmanda. So that Brahmanda is what? It is Maya, Maya Karya. Itham Ishvara, Ishvara Bheda Siddhyati. So merging into Maya, which is Ishvara Shakti, is merging into Ishvara. Parantu mathakashena yatha ghatakashasya abheda siddhyati sacha mathakashaha mahakashatmana eva vartate. Now although the merger in the example also, ghatakasha merging with mathakasha also, by saying that directly there is no merger possible with mahakasha, still what is mathakasha? परंतु मठाकाशेन यथा घटाकाशस्य अभेद सिद्ध्यति सच मठाकाशः महाकाशात्मना एव वर्तते. That मठाकाश is not different from महाकाश. Thereby, सगुण merger of the विदेह मुक्ता is not different from निर्गुण or the शुद्ध चैतन्य merger as well. Nirguna Brahma cannot answer our prayers. That's why we need someone to pray to. That someone can be in any gender, in any form, as explained earlier in the Upasana Prakarana. However, never should we be thinking that this Ishvara is not Sachidananda Brahma. Bhashantare Asya Granthasya Rachanayam Hetu. So the text is over, but the author, Sadhu Nishchala Dasaji, he justifies why he created this Grantha in Avadhi Hindi. There were a lot of objections to the work being created in Hindi because it is not a Sanskrita language per se. Sanskrita is Samyakkritam. In Sanskrita, there is Punya. In the right Uchcharana, there is Punya. Because it is Devanagari Bhasha, it is not a Paurushiya Bhasha, it is not man-made. every other language is man-made or it is a corrupted form of Sanskrita, but Sanskrita by itself is not man-made, it is Apurusheya. Because Vedas exist in that language, Vedas are Apurusheya, so it can also be inferred. How can it be so? So there are people who object, no, how can it? They'll give you all this Greek and Latin stories, they'll tell you is Indo-European languages and all that hierarchy, all that is bogus. We are Vaidikas. Shraddha should be there in Vedas. Not only as Veda is Pramana, but Apaurusheya. Apaurusheyatvat Vedasya Pramanyam. Shabda Bodha takes place and gives you knowledge of each and every sentence. Not only in Vedas, in Laukika also, because there is a Nitya Sambandha of the Pada and Padartha. So the Pada, as it is in the uttered Shabda in Vedas, which is the Ishvara Shvasa, that is Apurusheya Grantha. From there we have got these words. From there we have got the Vyakrana, and then we got Rupa Siddhi of many other words also. So this language is Samyakrutam. Since Veda is Pramana, this Sanskrita also should be spoken in that very manner. Therefore, the Vedangas, Shiksha Ityadi, which is the pronunciation. The pronunciation being right, you will get Punya as well. Now, this kind of language in which the Shastra Granthas exist, why would anyone create a Grantha in any other language? This is the objection which the Sadhu will have faced. So, he had to justify it. He justifies it. Bhashantare, meaning Hindyam, Avadi Hindyam, Granthasya Rachanayam, Hetu Kaha Hetu. What is the reason that you have done so? He answers that. He says, Itham Aneka Vedanta Siddhanta Ratna Garbhita Ayam Vichara Sagarakhya Grantha. And we have studied this Grantha in its entirety. We know that it is befitting the name of Vichara Sagara. It is definitely this Sagara of Vichara. It is like a Mahabharata of Vichara, if you look at it. All sorts of Vicharas have been done. There is no front which has not been discussed. No other Prakrana Grantha covers this kind of vastness. So, Itham Aneka Vedanta Siddhanta. There are so many Vedanta Siddhantas which you are finding in one place. Therefore, Siddhantara Aneka Vedanta Siddhanta Ratna Garbhitaha. So such kind of gems have been embedded in this work by the Sadhu, and thereby he calls this as Vichara Sagara Vivekataha Prakatikrutaha. With Viveka he has presented it in as simple a manner as possible. You cannot get any simpler explanation than this, the way the text has been dealt with, because he wants it to reach to people who do not have the capacity to understand the intricacies, or may not have the adhikara in other granthas also. So he wants everyone to get moksha and make things as simple as possible for them, giving all sorts of details. So krutsnam aditam vyakaranam Sankhya Nyayadi Shastranyabhi Shramena Samagram Avalokitani. What did he have to do for that? Only one who has studied a lot can make things simpler. Just because somebody gives you an understanding which is very easy for you to understand does not mean that that person does not know all details. It in fact means that each and every question is answered to the Shishyas, each of the Shishyas' level of understanding. That means that the creator of such a work has to have the complete overview of all Shastras and detailed understanding also of all Shastras. So he says, what did he have to do for that? He had to study entire Vyakarana, Sankhya Nyayadi Shastrani Abhi Shramena Samagram Avilokitani. He had to study all Darshanas also. Asheshaha Advaita Vedanta Granthascha Parishilitaha. then Advaita Grantha, he had to completely study in depth all sorts of Tikas and Prakarana Granthas. Na anavalokita asti grantha ekopi. He did not leave anything to chance. He studied all granthas which are available. Atyanta katinaha duruha matantara siddhantaha pi atishramena avagahitaha. He had to study other matas also, although it is not an interest area of the sadhu. Why would someone study something else? Because he wants to tell you that what exists there and why you should avoid it. Otherwise, there is curiosity. He said that even with that difficulty, Ruchi wasn't there, but still he had to study all the other granthas also, which is anti-siddhanta. Chatura api vedan apashyam samagram. All the four Vedas he had to look into completely. Athapi maya ayam vichara sagarakhya grantha bhashayam eva akari. Still he says that all those that I studied, they were in Sanskrita. This grantha I created in a different language, in bhashayam means in Avadhi Hindi. Na viladje bhasha rachanayam. He had no shame, so to say. He said that I didn't find anything wrong in creating this in non-Sanskrit. परोपकार चिंता एव अत्र हेतुः. व्हाट इज द हेतु? परोपकार चिंता, लोक संग्रह. ही वांटेड टू रीच आउट टू पीपल हू नो, हू डू नॉट हैव व्याकरण, इवन इफ दे हैव सम संस्कृत, और दे मे नॉट इवन हैव सो मच ऑफ संस्कृत विच इज नीडेड फॉर अदर ग्रंथ स्टडी. देयरफॉर टू रीच आउट टू देम विद परोपकार चिंता, ही क्रिएटेड दिस ग्रंथ इन भाषा. व्याकरण ज्ञान विना संस्कृत ग्रंथ मंद बुद्धि भिर न शक्यन्ते पठितुमपि. व्याकरण मुखम स्मृतम. विदाउट व्याकरण यू कैनॉट स्टडी एनी संस्कृत ग्रंथ. इट इज नॉट अ स्टोरी. यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड इंट्रिकसीज. इंट्रिकसीज आर हिडन इन प्रकृति एंड प्रत्यय. सो विद प्रकृति एंड प्रत्यय ज्ञान यू गेट दि तिंगंत ज्ञान, यू गेट दि पद ज्ञान, सुबंत ज्ञान. देयर बाय शाब्द बोध इज पॉसिबल. Otherwise, you cannot understand the intricacies which are hidden. Then you can use every other skill to apply on this, each and every pada in the sentence. But then vyakrana is needed. Bhasha prabandham tu anayasena patitva pamara api paramanandam anubhaveyuhu iti. However, pamaras who are not scholars, just regular people, can understand it in other languages. Now this Avadhi is difficult for people who have not studied it, but then, you know, village people in that area were easily able to pick up this because it is their local language. Anyway, so that is the idea, that is the reason he created this Grantha in Hindi. Just give me one moment, please. Mangalacharanam. Grantha Samaptischa. So at the end, there is a Mangalacharana of this Grantha. So, and this is the Mangalacharana of the Sadhu himself. Hastinapuratah Paschad Yojanashtadashanvite. This should be Grametu Keha Daulyakhe Granthoyam Rachito Bhavat. So this Grantha was created in Kihadaulya Grama, which is Ashtayojana Desha, separated out from Hastinapura. We know Hastinapura, the center of Mahabharata. Videha Mukti Samaye Yena Abheda Prapedire Brahmanishtastatha Veda Karanam Yastuvantihi Vyavruttanam Rupatma Jagatyanugatantuyatu वेदांत वेद्यम तल्लक्ष्यम अस्थिभाति प्रियात्मकम एकं निरूपमं तत्त्वं शुद्धाद्वैतं चिदात्मकं विषयावगमं ज्ञानं स्वयं विषयवर्जितम्. सो ब्रह्मनिष्ठाः तथा वेदाः कारणं यस्तुवन्ति हि. सो दिस कारण ब्रह्म इन Stuti also, that Karana Brahma should be in the mind and then leading to Brahmanishta. See, Brahmanishta Stuvanti, those who have Brahmanishta, they praise. Who are these Vedas? Who has Brahmanishta? Here Brahmanishta can mean, generally Brahmanishta, Pullinga, is what? Is Brahmani Nishthayasya. Now we talk about that as a Jnani, Jivan Mukta Jnani, as Brahmanishta. But Nishtha means commitment. Not only abidance, it can also mean commitment. In the case of Jnani, Jivan Mukta Jnani, we say Brahmanishta, meaning he has Brahmani Nishtha, he has abidance in Brahma. But in this case, it is in Samanadikarana with Vedas. What are Vedas? Vedas do not have abidance. Vedas have commitment. Tatparya Vishaya. What is that? That is Brahma. So Brahmani Nishtha Yesham Vedanam Te Vedaha Brahmanishtha Vedaha. So those Brahmanishtha Vedas, what do they praise? They praise Karana. Because they are committed to Brahma, they praise not the Karya but the Karana. Looking at all the Karya, you should be able to land on the Karana, which is Brahma. Understanding the Veda Vakya, Vyavrutta Nama Rupatma Jagat Tyanugatam Tuyatu. And that itself is manifest in the form of the entire Prapancha, pervading in and through the entire Prapancha. Manifest now. Vedanta Vedyam. And that Karana can be known only through Vedanta. Jnanena Moksha, only through Upanishad Jnana. Tal Lakshyam, and it is Lakshya. Laksharta has to be known. What is that Laksharta of that Karana Brahma? Karana Brahma Jagat Karana is Tatastha Lakshana. Swarupa Lakshana is Satchidananda, otherwise called as Astibhati Priyatmaka. So that Laksharta of Karana also is Astibhati Priya, meaning Satchidananda. Ekam Nirupamam, and it is Eka, Ekam Evadvitiya, it is Nirupam, there is no comparison possible. All comparisons, all Udharanas which are given, they are on the sidelines. They cannot be exact. Ekadesha comparison is possible, not Purna. If you compare Purna in any example, not only here, but in any example, an example is an example only because not everything is same. If everything is similar, then it is same. It is not similar. Then it is not an Udharana. It is the exemplified itself. It is no longer an example. Here all the more so, Nirupamam, although there is nothing that can compare with this Satchidananda Ananta Brahma, since there cannot be two infinities, therefore this Brahma is beyond Upama. That is the reality, Tattva. And Tattva, elsewhere Bhagavan Bhashyakara says, what is Tat? Tat is Sarvanama. Tat is Sarvanama. And what does it stand for? Tattva means Tasya Bhavaha. Tasya Bhavaha Tattvam. Tasya Bhava Tva Talu. That Tva is added to Tat, you get Tattvam. Kasya Bhava? Tat is Sarvanama. Sarvanama stands for Sarva. Therefore, Tat stands for Sarva. Therefore, Sarvasya Bhavaha. Sarvesham Bhavaha. What is it? Tattvam is Sarva Bhavaha. It is the very essence of everything, swarup of everything is this Brahma. Therefore called as Tattva, meaning Sarva Bhavaha. Shuddha Advaita. Ekameva Dvitiya Shuddha Advaita. Never tainted, even while being in this Prapancha, one is free. That is this Brahmatma Advaita Chidatmakam. It is the very nature of consciousness. Vishyavagamam. Jnanam Swayam Vishayavarjitam. That which can be known with each and every Vishaya. No Vishaya can exist. You cannot objectify it. But no object can exist without the Satta and Spurana being lent from Brahmatma. Therefore, this Avagama, Jnana, is possible. Where is it possible? You take anything. Yatra yatra mano yati tatra tatra samadaya. Wherever your mind goes, there itself, wherever mithya is, there itself satya is. This tattva is there everywhere because it is all pervasive. Vibhutvat. Vibhutvat sarvatra asti tattvam. So where should I look for it? Where should I hunt for this Brahma? Wherever your mind goes, you can look at it there. Oh, but I am an introvert. I want to stay with myself. Okay, being an introvert, within you also there is Brahma. Without you also there is Brahma. There is no within and outside division possible. That kind of Brahma which pervades the prapancha as its very substratum. But itself is untainted, therefore shuddha and also bereft of that vishaya. So vishaya varjitam swayam, vishaya varjitam sat, swayam vishaya varjitam sat vishayavagamam. It is known through this jnana is possible by analyzing any vishaya. Every vishaya becomes a linga for understanding this Brahma, because you just have to understand the mithyatva and know that without satya adhishthana there cannot be mithya, and that adhishthana is Brahmatma, very you, swarupa of your own self. Now, having said that, there is, although this is done, we'll look at this rahasyartha. What has been mentioned about Ishvara, Saguna and Nirguna, there is a tippana which is clarifying that. Although it is clear in the Mula, still a further clarification which is not discussed elsewhere, therefore it is rahasyartha. Jnani drishtya videha muktehe pragapi brahmandadikam jaganna kinchidapi vidyate kintu brahmeva kevalam vartate. So even before videha mukti, from the perspective of the jivan mukta jnani, this brahmanda jagat does not exist at all. Kinchidapi na vidyate, because jnani is of that an uttama jnani. His vision is what? Tuchchatva in prapancha. Kintu brahmeva kevalam vartate, he himself exists, there is nothing else. Tasmad vidvad drishtya shuddhena brahmana eva abheda vidusha. So this vidvan has already merged with nirguna brahma, merging being figurative. There is an abheda with nirguna brahma. Sa eva tasya shuddha brahma prapti, and that itself is nirguna brahma prapti or shuddha brahma prapti in jivan mukti. Ajna drishtya tu pragiva brahmanadaya pratiyante tasmat tadrishtya jnanina ishwarena ishwaradeha bhuta brahmanena abhedo jayate. But the perspective of the ajnani is that, this jnani has sharira. So after sharira falls, he will merge with Ishvara. So it is from the perspective of the jiva. I already mentioned this in the Mula. Sa api Ishvaraha paramarthata shuddham brahma eva. He is shuddha brahma. Anena jnanina shuddha brahma praptireva bhavati. Videha mukto jnani jivasteyo. Brahma bheda tasmin abhasadi nana prakara vedanta paksha shashte tarange sangrahena nirupita. So it has been discussed as to how this Ishvara is one with Nirguna Brahma, and in Vivarana Sampradaya is the Bimba for this Jiva who becomes Pratibimba. So that is the part of the prayer. Then I'll just finish this off. Akhandam Sachidanam Mano Vagadya Gocharam Sarvesham Pratyagatmanam Param Brahma Bhavami Tat Aham Eva Param Brahma Mai Sarvam Prakalpitam Iti Yat Krupaya Buddham Sadgurum Tam Namamyaham. So akhandam sachidanandam, we know this, nothing more to be mentioned there. Mano vak adi agocharam, so not accessible to any indriya, and also manas, meaning not an object of any indriya or any other pramana, and also cannot be objectified by manas the way it is written in upasana. Sarvesham pratyagatmanam param brahma bhavami tat. So that, who am I really? The sadhu says, I am that parabrahma who is atma in each and every jiva, meaning one who shines forth as aham aham. So aham aham spurana in each and every jiva, animals, birds, humans, devatas, rakshasas alike, insects and viruses alike, that aham pratiti is of that Brahma who I am. Aham eva param Brahma, that param Brahma I am, and in my antakkarana, not antakkarana, the antakkarana itself, in that kind of Brahma me, everything is prakalpita, prakarshena kalpitam, with a vyavastha it is imagined. Iti yat krupaya buddham, Who is that? That is my guru. He offers his namaskaras to his own guru. He says that kind of knowledge I got from whom, who himself is Brahma, I, who is Sadguru also, Sat Swarupa Brahma, Sat Cha Asau Guruscha, Tam Sadguru Aham Namami. Then the last avarta there is by the Tippanakara Swami Sadashiva Vasudev Brahmendra. So he says, Asya Grantha Samskruta Bhashaya Rachanayam Hetu. What is the reason I translate in Samskruta Bhasha? So he has to justify that also. He said, Divyam Bhasham Parityajya Shanya Bhasha Krutani Vai Shastrani Ye Prashrunvanti Te Vai Nirayagaminaha. Bahu Pramanair Ityadi Vachanair Ninditattvatah Chittasya Shuddhaye Chaiva Samskarartham Iyam Krutihi Aushadhadau Phaladikyam Anupana Balatsputam Anena Sarva Shastrartha Saras Suvidito Bhavet. So general explanation, understanding of all Panditas is that Phalaprapti is there only when it is in Samskruta. So, having given up other bhashas, one should take to Samskruta for many reasons. But then he says that Shastrani ye prashrunanti te vai nirayagamina. So, they don't. Anya bhasha, if you study, then there is no siddhi per se. Bahu pramani, and there are so many pramanas by which the other bhashas are nindita. Every bhasha may be shreshta in their own this thing, but they are all corrupted languages. Nobody praises the corrupt. Everyone does ninda of the corrupt. Therefore, other bhasha kritis are considered as corrupted forms of Sanskrita. So, when you can get a non-corrupted form, why would you go to corrupted form? With this thinking, I have made this. This is what the Swami says by and justifies it. Chittasya Shuddhaye Chaiva Samskarartham Iyam Kruti. And then why did he do it? Because he got to study it, and then he says that this has led to Chitta Shuddhi also. So Samyak Krutam with Punya Prapti, just Samskruta study will give you Punya Prapti. In fact, it is said that those who do not have Adhikara in four Vedas, they can study, just listen, not study also, even listening to Vyakarana Sutras will lead to Shuddhi. This is a vachana. So Ashtadhyayi Sutras being chanted or heard will lead to Shuddhi, Chitta Shuddhi also. So Punya Prapti. So Aushadhadav Phaladikyam. So this is working like a medication. It will work like medication. Therefore, there will be more phala if you follow Samskruta. And it is very clear. It is nothing more to explain the circles. It is in Pandita circles, it is very common. Even to this day, orthodoxy teaching is in Samskruta. The core subjects are always taught in Samskruta. You'll see, if you go around and see, in orthodoxy, the teaching is in Samskruta, because in other, you already know that the difficulty you are finding, I find it too difficult to use appropriate words, and you see that I don't translate these words because they cannot be translated. Many of these Samskruta words cannot be translated. You have to understand for what the word is with many phrases from different languages, and then you stick to Samskruta once the arthotpatti takes place. Once you understand the shabda, you stay with that. Avidya, mithya cannot have any equivalent in any language. So that is the case why it was anena sarva shastrartha sara suvidito bhavet, and thereby every bit of Shastra can be understood clearly with this Samskruta Vichara Sagara. Jivan Mukti, Videha Mukti, Varnanam Nama, Saptamastaranga Samapta, Granthascha Samapta. So the 7th chapter called as Jivan Mukti, Videha Mukti description is over, and so is the Grantha also, so is our Patha also. So thanks for letting me staying back, first of all, with all my hiccups with delays and stuff like that, cancellations. So thanks for staying the course. Thanks for giving me an opportunity to share this, study this and share. It has been a blessing through and through. With Ishwara's blessings, we have been able to finish this, complete the study. Hopefully, it will be useful in your mukti. And please continue studying. I will take a break from here on for health as well as my studies. I'll see you when I see you. So, best wishes. Namaskara.
Dhanyavada. Very, very, very thank you.
You're welcome. Dhanyavada. Thank you, thank you. You're all welcome. So, I will have made mistakes, so I accept all my flaws, but whatever is good is definitely owed to the Sampradaya. So, that is something that I have not mentioned, because with all your efforts, there will be errors in reading, there will be errors in explanations. So, I have tried my best. Hopefully, it will be useful. Namaste. Sukha Nityam Swaprakasham Vyapakam Namrupi Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhir Drukyatvam Param Sarva Vedanta Vedyam Pratyak Paramata Devannamattva Nitime Nishchitamatihi Om Tat Sat Sarvam Brahmarpanamastu. Namaste.